recorded, so you have them to save. Cool. So we will be screen sharing during the meetup. Quick reminder, if you've got headphones, highly recommend going and getting those headphones. It's going to make a big difference in your experience being able to hear us throughout the meetup. I'm Amelia.
I'm Kier.
We're calling from Mountain View, California. So we're in the San Francisco Bay Area. And super excited to have you all join us today. We try to do these once a month. The general format is we'll go through about 5 to 7 songs is kind of what we target each time. And then we'll always close Aloha, Aloha Oi at the end. We screen share. It'll be default. You guys will be default muted. We'll be unmuted. Definitely like feel free to throw stuff in chat. That definitely helps us out. And let's see, anything else that's important to share? The recordings get uploaded to my YouTube account afterwards. Did I get it all?
Mm-hmm.
So, okay. Yeah, I think so. All right, cool. All right. Well, we were finishing up this playlist this morning, so this may be a bit of an adventure for us, but it'll be good fun. We're all gonna have fun going along with it, and I'm sure we'll enjoy. So, okay, cool. Let me just check. I think we're gonna go ahead and just mute everybody. Do you think you can help me out with that, Kier?
I think you need to do it.
I have to do it?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. Mute all. All right. Okay. Well, you know, had to do this one for you, Michael, and any other Taylor Swift fans out there. I see you clapping over there. So, as you may have heard, Taylor Swift is like re-recording her whole catalog. And Love Story was one of the ones that came out recently. And, you know, I can't lie, I've got a lot of nostalgia for this song from, like, you know, I was in college or something. Maybe. Oh, hold on. I just pulled out our headphones. Okay, we're back. Please let us know if there's any sound issues because I totally just pulled the cord out. Okay. So I thought this would be a nice one to start with. We've got C, G, A minor, and F. There are a couple other chords that come in because there is a key change later on, but go ahead and check out those chords if these are new to you. So we've got our C, again, just a quick reminder, the way that Ultimate Guitar kind of likes to note these things is they'll put like a 3FR, meaning pretend this is the third fret. So this is really just the, you know, the familiar old C diagram that you're probably used to seeing. They just write it a little funny, that's all, and it's just because I use this site. So we've got C, G, A minor, F, and then a couple things to kind of watch out for here. Later on in the song, there is a key change. There's a key change near the end, and so that's where you'll start seeing these D's, A's, and B minors come in. So just kind of watch out for that. B minor, if you have not, if it's your first time playing this chord, give that a try. It's a bar chord. I'm just gonna zoom in on what that looks like up here in the top right. So it's gonna be, you're gonna take your index finger, you're gonna smush it across the strings on the second fret, then you're gonna use, I use my ring finger to kind of reach across and get the fourth fret on the G string. So you wanna do a little demonstration too?
I do the same as you, I just don't use two fingers.
I know, you're better about it. I brace. Sometimes people frown on. I do use my middle finger to brace my index finger for the B minor. But go ahead and give that a try if that's new to you. If that's sort of a, you know, if you're like, I don't really love that chord, don't worry. It's not in most of the song. Other things to kind of watch out for in this song are let me see. Please don't go. And I said, there are a couple times when the timing of the chords will be just a little bit faster. So I'll show you how this sounds here. So I'll be like, you know, Romeo, you were throwing pebbles and my daddy said, stay away from Juliet. So this is all pretty predictable. On the staircase, beg, and then please don't go. F, and I said, Romeo. So that F and that G go twice as quickly because we're kind of leading back into the C for the chorus, right? Begging you, please don't go. F, G, C. So just kind of watch out for that. I'll do my best to try to give a little bit of a heads up when stuff like that is happening, or try to kind of emphasize it a little bit. What else we got? This also happens between the verse and things like the pre-chorus and the chorus. So this, for example, on verse one, we were both young when I first saw you. I closed my eyes. So you're like on the chords for a really long time. Standing there, two, three, four, one. On a balcony in summer air. You got a long time. Then when you get to the pre-chorus, that you were Romeo, you were throwing pebbles and my... So suddenly, right, we're switching twice as quickly. So I just kind of want to give a heads up that that will be happening. Last thing I want to point out, and again, if you've got questions, please throw them in chat. Oh, someone's asking about that. Can you help out? If you've got questions, just like throw it in the chat and on the bridge. We're going to play all these with one down strum per chord, just for like a little bit more dramatic effect. So I got tired of waiting. F. Wondering if you were ever coming around. So we'll strum for the rest of the song, and for the bridge, we'll do single down strums. This is a great song to just, if you kind of want an easy strum pattern, works great with the island strum. So island strum being down, down, up, up, down, up. So it'll sound like do, 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 do. Let's G. Follow along with me. We'll just repeat this chord progression, F. That's in the intro. Let's try it again. Go back to C. Here we go. C. G. And A minor. And F. Let's go with the verse. Here we go.
Story, baby, just say
G. I got tired of waiting. Single down strums. Wondering if you were ever coming around. My faith in you was fading. When I met you on the outskirts of town, and I said, Romeo, save me. I've been feeling so alone. I keep waiting for you, but you never come. Is this in my head? I don't know what to think. He knelt to the ground, and here comes the key change. Marry me, Juliet, you'll never have to be alone. I love you, and that's all I really know. I talk to your dad, go pick out a white dress. It's a love story. All right, what do we think? How do people like that one? Wave your hands at me if you were like, I like that one. I would do that one again in the future. Okay, all right, cool. All right, as always, if you've got questions or comments or anything, love to hear from you in chat. It's one of the things we miss is that we can't hear you guys.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. So next, can't feel my face. Oh, yeah. Okay, cool. This is a really cool song on ukulele because it just does not sound like something that you'd play on ukulele, but yeah. It's cool. Okay, so the pattern for this, let's see. So the pattern is, it goes G, 2, 3, 4, F, 2, 3, 4, A minor, 2, 3, 4, A minor, 2, 3, 4, G, 2, 3, 4, F, 2, 3, 4, A minor, 2, 3, 4. This is the chord progression for like the entire song. So if you got that, you got the whole song. So what we're gonna play with in this song is a little bit more of kind of like strum patterns. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna play it and then I'll write it out so you can see exactly how it's structured, and then we'll talk about like variations that you can do on it just to give the song a little more personality. So the strum pattern that we'll start with is gonna sound like G, F, A minor, A minor, G, F, A minor. So that's how it sounds. All right, but I'm gonna write it out over here. So we have this over on the side. One, E and a two, E.
I still have a little bit of trouble executing this strum pattern correctly, the one that's coming up. It sounds really cool when you get it though. Essentially you kind of fake strum at about double time, and then you add an extra down strum. Amelia will show you in a second.
I wonder if I can change the font. Guess not. Guess this is it. Okay. Well, all right, cool. Okay, so we have our 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a, so what are we actually playing here? We are playing, we're doing down strums on 1, the and of 2, and 4. So 1, the and of 2, and 4. So let's see, it's kind of like 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 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 4 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and so if you actually want to see like what it looks like written out, that's what it looks like. So I'm just going to keep kind of stacking variations underneath here. So these are like more things you can try. I promise I won't spend too long on this because I know we got other stuff to get to. But
this is a challenge drum for the for this.
No, meetup, it's not. This is just the chuck.
Oh, no,
the chuck on the two.
Oh, it's the next one. In this song.
Just shh. Okay. All right. So if I were doing this on a G, just on a G, when I add the chuck, now it sounds like one and two and three and four. I'll just hang on a G. And two. So if you are familiar with how to chuck, then you can throw the chuck on the two. One and two and three and four and five. Helping a demonstration here.
Sorry.
One and two and three and four and so that is what that pattern sounds like. We played that before actually in a couple different meetups, but if you're curious about, you know, what a chuck means, which is what I'm denoting with the little X there, it's this percussive effect that you can do on ukulele. We won't cover it today, but there's like tons of tutorials on YouTube. Just look up like how to chuck on ukulele. Sometimes we'll call it chunk. I've heard chunk as well, chuck or chunk. I think Cynthia Lynn has a really good tutorial. There's a bunch on the internet. So we're not going to go into these in a ton of detail, but I will just throw in a couple more variations for anybody who wants to kind of play with them. So you can also throw in an up strum on the right before the chuck. Then that starts sounding like that's what it sounds like when you throw in the up there. And then my favorite is actually this. This starts to get weirder and weirder to read as I keep stacking them up here, but okay, this is on the okay. This is, I'm gonna have to draw dotted lines to show what it is I'm trying to line up with here. Okay, I promise this does actually make sense.
Amelia is good at writing out all these rhythms. I can't understand them.
So
I have to just
well, yeah, yeah. I'll play it because you're totally right. Like it makes a lot more sense when you actually hear it. I'm just trying to show which beats these are supposed to line up with. So if you do this, then it sounds like on a G. This one really work is to lean on these two beats. So I'm not playing them all the same volume. Anyway, this is probably what we're going to use for today, but I just did want to kind of show you other variations so that you can kind of play around with them at home if you want to try learning some new strum patterns. So let's go ahead and I would choose one of these top two, whichever one you kind of like, and let's just hang out on this chord progression. Okay, so we're going to go do 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 do. 1 2 on the G. F. A minor. A minor. One more time. G. F. A minor. Here go the verse. And I know she'll be the death of me. At least we'll both be numb, and she'll always get the best of me. The worst is yet to come, but at least we'll both be beautiful and stay forever young. This I know, this I know. She told me don't worry about it. She told me don't worry no more. We both know we can't go without it. She told me you'll never be alone. I can't feel my face when I'm with you. But I love it. But I love it. always get the best of me. The worst is yet to come. All the misery was necessary when we're deep in love. This I know. This I know. She told me don't worry about it. She told me don't worry no more. We both know we can't go without it. She told me you'll never be alone. Oh, oh, oh. I can't feel my face when I'm with you. But I love it. But I love it. Recognize that song? You raise your hand if you're like, I recognize that song. I see a couple of hands. Yeah, it sounds really different, like on ukulele, but it's super catchy. Yeah, definitely recommend it.
It's a Max Martin authored piece. Same person who did a bunch of Taylor's stuff from, I think it was 1989.
Max Martin. Max Martin's done like everything.
Yeah,
he's like all the major hits of the 90s. He was basically like the producer on them. All right, cool. Let's go ahead and move on to Someone Like You. It always drives Kier crazy when I start singing this song. I feel like I've like belted it out in the car. Never mind, I'll find someone like you. Okay, so
watch out for the D6.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Let's talk about the D6. So I like to use most this for the D6. Yeah, it's a really cool chord, this D6. So it's a bar, just a straight bar across, second fret. Really cool sounding. Sounds really neat. If it drives you crazy, you can just substitute a regular old D. Perfectly fine. So you'll see it. You'll see the D6 show up down here. And again, totally fine if you want to substitute in a D. What else we got here? We got our B minor coming back. So, you know, if you wanted to practice your bar chords, good chance to do that. Let's talk a little bit about the chord progression. So let's talk about this, like, I heard you're, so it's gonna go like G. I heard that you're, and you're gonna need to rearrange to get over to the B minor. Settle down that you. So what you can do on the B minor is, If you finger it such that like your index finger is only on strings 2, 3, and 4, so you're leaving the G string open really, and you're just doing 2, 3, and 4, and then reaching across with your ring finger for the B minor. Then to get to an E minor, you actually don't have to move very much. You can move you leave your index finger where it is, take the middle finger, plop it down on the third fret of the E string, or third fret of the third string over, and then your ring finger next to it. So you've kind of already made your little staircase shape for your E minor. So you can go from B minor to E minor that way without having to like rearrange your entire hand. So you can do that. And then to get to the C after that, right, because we're on E minor now, you can, instead of kind of going all the way back down, you could just move your middle finger over one and call that a C. Instead of having to like move your whole hand down, you know, to get to your ring finger down there. So just like a little way to save your, you know, you can just try this and see if you like this transition better. Just kind of saves your whole hand a little bit of movement. If you really want to get ambitious, you can do a little bit of a different fingering for G. So instead of doing our traditional G, which, you know, usually we kind of finger it like this, you could try to do everything sort of centered around the second fret. So if you take your first finger, again, you're going to take, you're going to do strings 2, 3, and 4. So the C, E, and A string, you're going to leave the G string open, take your middle finger, plop it down to the third fret of the E string to get your G. So you can do that. If you start on that as your G, then it's maybe a little easier to get over to the B minor because your index finger is already where it needs to be. So we've got your G, where you're already barring on the second fret. So now getting to the B minor, not that much movement, a little bit more movement to get to the E minor, and C. Then you could repeat it. So you could do this whole chord progression with your hand sort of centered around the second fret. So save yourself some moving around. Okay. The other thing to just call out about this song is that when we get to the pre-chorus, these chords are going to start changing twice as quickly. So over here, it'll be kind of like, you know, it'll sound like, old friend, why are you so shy? Ain't like you to hold back or hide from the light. I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay away, couldn't fight. So it just goes twice as quickly there. Just kind of watch out for that. What else? I think those are big things.
Yep.
Shall we give this a shot? Why don't we try, let's like loop on this chord progression at the beginning, as we like to do. Are you going to do, you want to do finger picking? You want to do, yeah, you're going to do finger picking?
Okay, yep.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, cool. We'll go 1, 2 on the G. And B minor. And E minor. And C. Let's do it again. To the G and G. I heard Yesterday was the time of our lives. We were born and raised in a summer haze, bound by the surprise of our glory days. I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay away, couldn't fight it. I'd hoped you'd see my face and that you'd be reminded that for me it isn't over. Hold, never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I beg, I'll remember you. Sometimes it lasts in love, sometimes it hurts instead. Yeah, bridge, nothing compares, no worries or cares, regrets and mistakes, they're memories made. Who would have known how bittersweet this would taste? To the chorus, never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you too. Don't forget me, I beg, I'll remember you said. Sometimes it lasts in love, sometimes it hurts instead. Here we go, never mind, I'll find, give it all your all. A hand. All right, what do we think of that one? Wave me if you like that one. That's a really pretty one. I like that one a lot. Okay, cool. And that's definitely one where you can kind of, I think it's a really nice one to play around with picking patterns on and things like that. Okay, cool. Before I move on, I did also want to say a huge shout out and thank you to everybody who last time was so generous as to offer to who sent me their email addresses to volunteer to help me and my team at work test this new release for this app that we work on. I just wanted to say, like, the whole team was extremely thankful. I told them on Monday, I said, I got friends who are going to help us test. And so, again, thank you so much. You know, if that's something you're still, like, totally zero pressure. If it's something you're wanting to help out with, and you're looking for a way to say thank you or something like that, send me your email address. And we're working on our next release at work. I need to find testers. So, all right, cool. I thought this would be kind of a fun one to try. So, I just thought this was really funny to try ukulele. So, never gonna give you up. Okay, cool.
This is pretty fun, actually.
Kier was cracking up when I got him to do this with me earlier. So let's just start with the chorus. Let me pin the chords. We got G, A. This F sharp minor, it's kind of like a G7. It's that same triangle shape, but just kind of moved over one string. So here's how the chorus is going to sound. It's going to sound like, never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you. So the last one here, it's a little bit different from everything before it. Never gonna make you cry, never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell a lie, can hurt you. All right. So that is that pattern. I'll do it one more time. Never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna run around and desert you. Never gonna make you cry. Never gonna say goodbye. Never gonna tell a lie and hurt you. Yeah, totally. Watching the check. Yeah, definitely a very classic yes. 80s tune.
And just think, after this, you can ask people, like, hey, do you recognize this melody?
Yeah, and then you can totally rickroll them on person. The ukulele, like in person. Exactly. It'll be great. Yeah, exactly. So, okay, let's talk a little bit about how you can get between those chords a little bit more easily. So you got your G, G, A from the A, right? You're really already at most of the F sharp minor shape. Just keep your A where it is. Take your ring finger, plop it down on the second fret, right? Now you're A. There you go. You're at your F sharp minor. Okay. I don't think I have anything clever for you, yeah, unfortunately, on how to go from F sharp minor to B minor. If somebody else does, definitely let me know.
The only thought I have is just that my hand is more like this, and then I just rotate my whole hand down to position my index finger so that it's ready for the bar.
What do you do?
Essentially, I just pivot. So this finger is in the same place. So you move down and then pivot your whole hand.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Like a guide on the...
Kind of use it like an anchor. Yeah. Just kind of like scooch your index finger down one fret and yeah, be like, exactly. All right, cool. I'm in the right place for my bar.
Your whole hand. Something I mean, like you can do it real fast. Of course.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Once you're at the B minor, you can, potentially, instead of resetting all the way back down to the G, right? You could lift your ring finger and place your middle finger down on the third fret of the third string. So that is a faster way to get from B minor to G.
One idea here was a B minor 7 instead.
I thought about it. I tried the B minor 7. So B minor 7, good call. Like if the B minor is giving you a pain, you can do a bar on the second fret, B minor 7. It sounds okay. It definitely sounds like a little bit off, but like you can get away with it. Yeah, I agree. You could try that. So thanks for the tip, Celia. That wasn't Celia. That was Carla. Back up to the B minor. So let you down. And then you could go to the G this way. Run around and desert you. So I think now we've gone through kind of all little tricks of how you could get from one chord to another, that I have anyway. Carlos says, my hands are too small to play B minor. I do not believe you because yes, you should see how small I am. Here. You cannot tell on Zoom, but I am 5 feet tall. I'm not even 5 feet tall. I'm 4'11 and 3/4". This is how big my hand is compared to Kier's. I'm like a child. And I play this is a tenor. This is not even so it's actually a larger than normal ukulele. So I believe in you, Carla. Okay, fine. All right, I'm 32, so I guess I'm not old yet. But I do believe in you. I do believe in you. Yes. There's hope. There's hope, because I never would have thought I could play bar chords, you know? I certainly not bar chords on a larger than normal instrument, so... I feel ya.
my one tip on bar chords, if you have trouble, is that is essentially practice, but try not using too much strength. That's usually the mistake.
Oh, like pushing too hard.
They push too hard, and you can't hold it. You can't do it. It's hard. Is you want to learn to press just hard enough.
I think the biggest thing is you just got to experiment with your hand. For every single person, the way that's going to work for you to bar is so different. Like, it could be like just a little bit of a difference of like how far you are. It's so specific to people. So I think that matters the most at the beginning, is like you just gotta find that magic spot, and then you can start figuring out like how much pressure to put on or off.
And you can use Amelia's trick, two fingers, which...
Oh, the bracing?
Yeah, you know, I don't have to do, but...
I do that. It's a little bit of my crutch.
Gives a little bit more strength.
Probably some teachers would frown on me for that though. Okay, so we've talked about the chorus. We got the chorus, and everything else is pretty standard. So it's just like, we're no strangers to love. You know the rules, and so do I. Okay, so that was not too, like, that was not too complicated. You're just going back and forth between G and A.
The only complicated thing is the timing of the lyrics.
Do. Oh, yeah, the lyrics are actually kind of hard to sing, I discovered. I was like, wow, I know the chorus really well, but, like, the verses are still trickier.
Yeah.
Okay, are you going to, you're playing for me?
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'm going to log out of this Zoom. Actually, why don't we try and see if it works?
That's not going to work. It doesn't make sense.
But I don't see, I don't think you're on. Let me just try.
All right. Well, we're on a time limit. I'd already set it up. See, it echoes.
Yeah, okay.
Told ya.
All right. Sorry, everyone.
It's like a weird game of sound engineering over here to get this meetup working. It's like so many circles of we have like two laptops and a mic and two headphones.
We're gonna
and
leave
like,
the chat
like,
for a minute. Sorry, everyone.
It's like quite a production over here. So we're trying to figure out how to do something a little bit creative to pipe in the actual song.
All right, is this transposed?
Yeah, I already set it up and everything. You just gotta start from the beginning and make it a little louder. We're gonna start on the verse when it gets there. Do, 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 do. I think it's getting close. Here we go. We're no strangers to love. You know the rules, and so do I. A full commitment's what I'm thinking of. Wouldn't get this any other guy. I just wanna tell you. Entire song is super long, but hopefully you enjoyed. Give yourselves. You can now rickroll anyone.
Yeah.
On command. Ukulele.
I totally have to try this at some point.
Just peg it on me. Like, you know, this would be a great thing to do at open mic. You're just like, I got a great song. I'm gonna surprise you, and then you just like pull this out. Exactly. Okay. Cool. So, in our last few minutes, we're going to do Hey Soul Sister, then we're going to do Brown Eyed Girl, and then we'll do La Hoy. So, I think we've done a lot of songs today that I think we haven't done before in the meetup. So, this one, Brown Eyed Girl, we have done before. Okay, so C, G, A minor, F. Things to just note here, we are going to have to jump back to the chorus. The chorus is here in this box, and then every time we hit repeat chorus, we're gonna come back and play the thing in the box. So you just kind of gotta be prepared. Just gotta know, time to jump back to the box. This C here, you can kind of ignore. Sort of like when you're going from the chorus down to here, the C is, these are really the same C. So I'm just kind of gonna correct that real quick. And then you'll also notice there's a couple places where we've got these split chords. just kind of moves, means you're going to move between them twice as quickly. All right. This is a great song to use essentially a fast variant of the island strum with. So if you want to try it, it sounds like on a C, it'll sound like. Okay, so you can just kind of think of it as that. Now, if you really want it to sound like the original song, then what you want to do is you want to lean on beats 2 and 4. So it'll sound like down, down, up. Ugh. That's my terrible handwriting over here. Okay, you're going to really lean on these two down strums. And what that means is that conversely, you're going to make everything else way lighter. So it's going to sound like this. So all I'm doing is I'm just 3, 4. Just kind of giving it a little bit more oomph. And then to help that pop, I'm making everything else super light. So if you do that, then it'll really sound like the original song. And then, let's see. I feel like that's most of it. So let's go ahead and loop on the C, G, A minor, F. Just maybe once or twice before we start the song. So we'll go like 1, 2, ready, play, C. And G.
Tonight, hey, 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 hey.
clapping, so I'm guessing people liked that one. People liked that one? Okay. All right, good to know. Good to know. It's always helpful for us to, I'm always keeping track of, you know, which ones are the popular ones to file away for future.
Nice. Michael saw them play live.
Really? Oh, wow. That's really cool. All right. I'm trying to get back to my list here. Cool. We're going to do Brown Eyed Girl, and then we shall wrap up. I did have a bonus one. I had Amy Winehouse Rehab. Really cool chords. So that's a fun one to play around with, you know, at home afterwards when you're bored. Okay. So, hey, now, do-do-do. We've talked about this in the past. If this D7, the bar on the second fret is like not your favorite, one of my favorite cheats is the apparently it's known as the Hawaiian D7. It's basically a cheat form of the chord. Looks like this. So this is my alternate D7.
By Harvey. Ooh, it's Shoreline. Michael Solomon Shoreline.
Oh yeah. Oh cool. What else should do I want to call out about here? Not really. You know, there's not much here. I think there's not. I guess you do kind of have to watch out. So you can kind of get lulled into security here with the G, C, G, D. And you just kind of got to watch out down here. It's like, oh, wait, okay, all right, there's an E minor that pops in. So just kind of watch out for that. Just as a quick reminder, this is a tip we've talked about in the past, but to get from G to E minor, if you're on your regular old G, you can just reach your pinky over to get to the E minor. So you don't really have to, it just saves you a lot of moving, you know, to get between G and E minor versus having to reset your entire hand. So it's a quick tip there. All right, why don't we go ahead and jump into this? Let's go ahead and loop on the G, C, G, D at the beginning. So let's see, it's gonna go like, G, D. Here we go, G, C. We'll just loop this a little bit. Time. G. Here we go, here we go. Hey now, here we go. Days when the rains came down in the hollow, playing a new game. Laughing classic shalala laws going on over there. That's always the best part. I feel like that's the best part. Okay, cool. We're going to close out with Aloha Oi. Let me clear the doodles off my screen here. Before people drop off, leave us a comment on the meetup event of which songs you particularly liked. We love that. It really helps us out. Thanks for joining us today. Here we go. One, two, three. Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. I'm smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds and we're together? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. Happy trails to you. For joining. We hope you have a very lovely rest of the weekend, and we will see you in a month.
See you next time.
Bye, everybody.
Bye, everyone. Did you record?